Hi, BrenTech here, where tech is made simple. Microsoft OneDrive, the web version of OneDrive, can now be installed in both Microsoft Edge and in Google Chrome now as a progressive web app, or PWA for short. Now in Microsoft Edge, I'm just going to go over and launch my OneDrive, which is the web version and will open in the browser. And once that's loaded, you will see now in the top right in the address bar, you have an option, app available, install Microsoft OneDrive. And when we click on that, it says this site can be installed as an application. It will open in its own window and safely integrate with Windows features. And as mentioned in previous videos, basically what a PWA is it's a shortcut to a web page. And once that's installed into your browser, it will act independently of the browser, just like any native app on your operating system. And it doesn't get installed into your operating system, it gets installed into the browser. And I'm going to click on install, and that will take a second or two to install. And once installed, we have a couple of options here. Allow this app to pin to taskbar, pin to start, create desktop shortcut, auto start on device login. I'm going to stick to those defaults, click on allow, and now it acts independently of the browser, just like any native app on your operating system. And I'm actually going to close Edge, and we can maximize, minimize. I'm going to close the app, and once, because I've pinned it to my taskbar, I can launch it like any app straight from my taskbar. I can also launch it from my start menu. And due to the options I selected, it's placed it in my start menu as a tile. And also, yeah, it's also put an entry in the start menu itself. And I think this is quite a handy little feature, making OneDrive as a PWA, now making it available as a PWA, because I actually personally use OneDrive on a regular basis. So I think that's quite a handy little option now. And for whatever reason, you decide you don't want to use OneDrive as a PWA and would like to uninstall it, you have one or two options. You can, you know, go back to your start. This would be the easiest. And just right click on that entry and go uninstall. Or you can also, to uninstall it, you can head back to your browser, go to the top right, apps, and then you go to manage apps, click on that, and if you click on the X, you just go remove, and that will take it and uninstall it off of your browser. And as mentioned, this is also available as a PWA over in Google Chrome as well. So I hope you found this video useful. Once again, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.